Take a look at the following clip and see if you can find anything wrong with it. Well, anything at all? Well, in case you missed any of that, I'm gonna rerun it and explain it thoroughly. In this clip, I only fire two lock-on missiles. The first rocket here hits the opponent. The second one, my opponent uses flares. No biggie, that's what you should do when you're getting locked on. The problem is, when his flare activation runs out, that second rocket that he flared hits him anyway. The takeaway? Countermeasures in Battlefield 2042 do not work. Welcome to today's video, which is going to be more of a PSA than anything, and certainly shorter than a lot of my other videos. But the main point of the video is to attempt to spread the word with what little audience I have that the countermeasures in 2042 right now are a complete disaster, and they make flying aircraft in this game miserable at times. If you've ever been in an aircraft and you flared a rocket, and then right after your flares run out, you immediately got hit by another one, you didn't get hit by another one. You got hit by the exact same rocket that was originally fired at you. This problem persists constantly, and you can definitely see it in the background gameplay because it's not even something you initiate on purpose or abuse some sort of glitch to do. It just happens when you fire your lock-ons. As it is already, lock-ons are infinitely more powerful than your cannons on the jet, which is frustrating since lock-ons don't require any skill comparatively, but when you couple the already skillessness of the lock-ons to the fact that they're almost a guaranteed hit if you fire them, even if the opponent flares, well, it can get real annoying real fast. And sometimes it makes the jet lock-ons feel way more powerful than they otherwise would be. It's not just the jet lock-ons, though. This issue persists across every single lock-on in the game. FXM AA missile on infantry, same problem. Attack helicopter lock-ons, same problem. AA lock-ons, same issue. It's across all of them. Now, what exactly causes this? I can't say for sure. I have some hunches, and I think they're pretty good guesses, but I don't have a real answer for you. The best answer that I do have is that they tried to remedy the problem from the beta where lock-ons would just miss their target. And in trying to do that, they introduced, well, this problem. For those who didn't play the beta, in the beta, if you fired a lock-on rocket at someone, they could just maneuver their aircraft a certain way, especially the scout helicopter, and the rocket would just miss every single time. Obviously, that isn't great for game balance and is really frustrating when you fire a rocket at someone and they just go, I don't even need to use my countermeasures, and they turn right and you miss. So it seems to me like in order to combat that problem, they made it so that the lock-on tracking is a lot better and the lock-ons last a lot longer of a time. The problem seems to be that these two things in conjunction with each other is what's causing our problem. It's not just one of them, it's both of them. What do I mean by that? Well, let's take a look at an example so you can get a better idea. First of all, when you use your flares, you can see how long your flares are going to be active for. It's actually a nifty piece of information that you have access to, and I really appreciate it being there because it hasn't been there in the past. After you use flares, you can see the timer tick down on your flares, and once that hits zero, it'll start recovering your flares, as well as you'll be once again able to be locked on and hit by lock-on missiles. The issue is that the missile despawn timer and this little grace period where you can't be hit by rockets are drastically different, in that the rocket long outlasts the timer. Now that alone probably wouldn't be that big of a problem, because if the rocket was missed originally by the flares, then it probably would have hit the ground or something. But with the improved tracking, as you can see here, the missile goes in circles over and over again on the spot. I think you're probably starting to see what's going on here. The missile sticks around, spinning in circles at Mach 10 over and over again, and then, once your flares run out, it just continues on the path of destruction and hits you again. As it stands, if you don't either number one, get lucky and hope to God that the missile spazzes out and hits the ground, Or number two, get behind a building or some sort of object that can make sure when the missile relocks it hits something. Then if someone fires a missile at you, you're going to get hit. 9 times out of 10. I don't think I really need to tell you why this is a problem. Countermeasures are meant to stop rockets from hitting you, not delay the amount of time until they hit you. This is ignoring the fact that a lot of the time if you use your countermeasures, the rocket will just decide to hit you anyway. But I feel like that's just a legacy problem across Battlefield games that never really will get fixed. This is a new thing that we have to deal with, and oh man, it makes flying the jets horrid. Jets can only take 2 lock-on missiles before they die. That means that it's almost entirely up to chance when you both fire your lock-on rockets at each other who wins the fight. Because if one of your lock-ons decides to relock and hit after the flares, and one of them doesn't, then that person just wins by default. If you both hit each other, then it's gonna be a trade. And if neither of you hit each other, then you're back to square one and you try again. It makes fighting in jets even more linear than it would be. Every single fight goes the same. It's either a stomping or lock-on trades. Cannons a lot of the time don't play a role because the lock-ons are just so much better. Which is really a shame because the cannons are, well, the skilled way you shoot things down. Anyways, enough complaints from me. I'm not even some sort of ace pilot. I just figured that this should be somewhere on people's radar because I haven't seen it anywhere yet. Although I don't really know when this video will be coming out, so maybe people will be all over it before this releases. But assuming it's not, I hope someone larger than me may see this, and then it can become an exposed issue. Because I feel like it's one of those things that's kind of under the hood that could definitely fly under the radar. There are a lot of changes that are under the hood that could fly under the radar that I think I should just make a whole video showcasing all of them and hope that maybe my video reaches the right resources. But you know what? I suppose we'll just have to wait and see. With that, I'm done here. I know it wasn't really the normal video and I'm not having fun and playing the game, but this is just such a massive issue that just completely shuts down aircraft a lot of the time, which is something that I spend a good chunk of my time, and I think a lot of other people spend a good chunk of their time doing. And it took me a minute to catch on to what exactly was going on here, so I feel like there's a good chance that could be the same for others. Anyways, if you enjoyed the video, you can leave a like, subscribe. If you didn't, don't do those things. And with all that being said, have a wonderful day or night wherever you are, and I'll see you next time.